genomes and their implications for basic and applied research. Of course, those of you working on questions in cancer research already know that Dr. Rogelstein was the first researcher to elucidate the molecular basis of a common human cancer, and that his work on colorectal cancer forms the paradigm for much of the work that's being done in modern cancer research. If you haven't heard him before, Bert is a fantastic speaker, and he brings a unique worldview to the field of cancer genomics, and the themes he'll touch upon during his lecture will dovetail quite nicely with a lot of the themes that we're going to be addressing over the 13 weeks of this current topics lecture series. Please keep in mind that Dr. Goldstein's lecture will not be videocast, and it will not be videotaped. So please mark your calendars for next week, and I hope to see many of you over in the Natural Auditorium for Bert's lecture. So today, it's my great pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Elaine Lardis, who is a professor of genetics and molecular microbiology and the co-director of the Genome Institute at the Washington University School of Medicine. Dr. Lardis' involvement in the field of genomics dates back to the beginning of human genome sequencing when, in 1993, she joined the Genome Institute at WashU as its director of technology development. And in that role, she helped create methods and automation pipelines that were critical for sequencing the human genome. And if you think back to Dr. Green's lecture during the first week of this course, you'll recall the technological challenges that those that were working on the Human Genome Project in the early days of that project faced as they sequenced each and every one of the chromosomes that comprise the human genome. And Dr. Lardis was really one of the key players and thought leaders who helped to figure out how to best approach and operationalize such a huge biological and technological problem. In her current role as the co-director, she orchestrates the Genome Institute's efforts to explore next-generation and third-generation sequencing technology, some of which you'll hear about today. And the goal of that is to transition these technologies into a production sequencing environment that could serve as a very strong foundation for addressing really important questions in genetics and genomics. Dr. Lardis also has a very strong research interest involving the application of DNA sequencing approaches to the characterization of cancer genomes with a particular focus on facilitating the translation of basic science discoveries about human disease into the clinical setting. Her work and contributions to the field of genomics have been recognized by numerous organizations. Most recently, in 2010, she was awarded the Scripps Translational Research Award for her work on cancer genomics, and in 2011, she was named a distinguished alumna of the University of Oklahoma College of Arts and Sciences. I'm very pleased that Elaine could join us today and be part of this series presenting her perspective on next-generation sequencing technology. So with that, please join me in welcoming today's speaker, Dr. Elaine Lardis.
That was great. Well, good morning, everybody, and thanks again, Andy, for the kind invitation to be here and to provide an educational lecture for you on next-gen sequencing technologies. I believe I'm supposed to...